Zach, can you hear me? Testing. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. So are you taking Murphy right now? Okay. Let me know if you want to come to me. Thank you.
Thank you.
they just they put onto the screen the fact that Gopal is up with 8% of the vote, and so people were cheering.
Thank you.
Hey, Zach, if you can, come to me, because Gopal... Wait. It's not him. No. We thought we saw his car, but he's not here yet. No, it's not his car. I'm here. No, not yet. Yep. Yeah, no problem. We're just waiting on him. I actually texted Attila just now asking to call his campaign. Say that again. Thank you. Oh, my mic will work? Okay. Watching us online, you can see the people are here. This room is almost packed, and this crowd actually erupted in cheers because they projected on the board that Gopal is up as of right now. It was like 13% of the vote was in. But let's talk to some people since we have you guys with us. We actually spoke to this table right over here. Hello?
Hi.
Hold on, we're going to flip the camera around so I can talk to you. So this table right here, behind every great campaign, there are great people, and these are some volunteers. So how many doors have you knocked on throughout this campaign or made calls? And
We walked, we stuffed, and we phoned.
How many doors?
Oh, my God. We did 150 on Saturday alone. So we were out there hoofing it around.
What motivates you to go out there and make those calls for him?
Make a change. We need more
Democrats. We need more Democrats.
And what do you see in Gopal?
The future. Definitely the future.
We see somebody who's going to take care of us and not worry about the rich people.
And I don't know if you saw, but he's a little bit up right now. It's like 13% of the vote is in and he's slightly ahead. I heard everyone started cheering. Are you excited?
Yes, it was very exciting to see that. We can hardly wait to see some more.
Fingers crossed at this table.
Absolutely.
Great. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
So, you can see this is one table, and that kind of story you see all around this room. I mean, you can tap anyone on the shoulder, and you'll get the same kind of reaction. Look, I'll even show you right now. Hi, how are you? So, we're with NJTV News. What brings you here tonight?
Oh, the Democratic Party, the fact that we get a chance to see the thing on TV, and we were rooting for Gopal, and he won already, and we also rooting for the Murphy.
Which, he's great.
So we're really happy.
We're great.
What do you like about Gopal?
Gopal? I know him for a few years. He's a good man. He's a business owner. He used to run the Democratic Party in Mammoth County, I guess. So he's a kind of nice man. So I have a lot of hope for him.
What about you?
Same thing.
And I'm guessing this whole table has the same reaction.
Yeah.
All right. So people here are just very excited and. We are continuing to check our phones. We're actually sitting over here. This is like our makeshift desk over here that we built. And we are keeping track of these votes and hoping to hear what happens. Jennifer Beck is actually at Kim Guadagno's event. So we are also in contact with her team and we will keep you posted. But we will let you enjoy the sights and sounds of this room in the meantime.
doing the next one right now.
Dad, it's not for you.
Keeping this party going, we're still in action. I saw my photographer roaming around showing you guys. There's a lot of action here. Very good music. Hello.
Hi.
We're just stopping people.
Okay.
With NJTV News. Tell me, what brings you here tonight? Big supporter of Gopal?
Yes, very much so.
Did you help in the campaign?
We're members of the Chairman's Club. So in Monmouth County, yes, we did. We did whatever we could to help.
Yeah. And what draws you to this candidate?
He makes sense. He has the same kind of values and interests that I do. I happen to be the immediate past president of the State Nurses Association, and he's very much in tune with what is important to us.
And I don't know if you saw, but we're keeping track of the votes, and he's a little bit up. There was like 13% in.
It's coming. Yeah.
Getting excited?
I'm getting there. I'm very excited about Virginia, I'll tell you that.
Shout out to Virginia.
Thank you.
All right, we'll move this way. Hi, guys.
Hi.
You guys are too cute not to put on TV.
Thank you.
Who are you here with?
My dad.
Your dad.
I'm their best friend. Their dad is running for freeholder.
Oh, are you excited?
I'm so excited.
Why do you want your dad to win?
Because he's worked really hard, and he's really nice and good.
How old are you?
I am 10.
Have you helped him?
Yeah, kind of. I marched in a parade with him a lot, and it was really fun.
And did you tell all the kids in school to vote for him?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, I told everyone. It's a huge honor to be best friends with these guys because they're just amazing, and their dad, Brian Wilton, is amazing. So, good luck.
Where is your dad?
He's over there.
Oh, okay. Tell him you're a very good representative. You should be his campaign manager.
Yeah, I
can. Future politician?
What?
Are you going to run for office?
I don't know.
Maybe?
No. I want to become an actor.
So actor, we're good right here then.
Yeah.
She's in a play at Spring Lake Theater. She's Tiny Tim.
All right, good job. Thank you. High five.
Thank you.
Nice seeing you too.
Thank you.
Nice
seeing
you. High five. So cute. So you can see there's just so many different kinds of people here tonight, but they have one thing in common. They're all here to support Vin Gopal, and we will continue to monitor these results. And he hasn't arrived yet, but as soon as he gets here, we're going to try to talk to him and his campaign, and we will keep you posted.
NJTV.
NJTV.
Oh,
the crowd is cheering right now. You can hear me because they have projected on the screen Phil Murphy, and this crowd is very excited right now. told you, 63% of the vote is in. And Gopal is up. You just heard the crowd erupted in cheers because they put on the screen projection right now. 63% of the vote is in, and Gopal is up by 56%. That's why this room just erupted in cheers. We are continuing to monitor this count, and we are waiting for his arrival. We'll bring that to you as soon as possible.
Thank you.
Do you want to see? Do you want to take our shot? Just let me know. The crowd's gonna go wild.
We're gonna make history.
Let's give Joe a nice round of applause.
Do you hear me?
They're on their way. Hello.
How exciting is it here tonight?
Oh, it is very exciting. It's just so great to know that we're getting Christy and all his people out of the State House in Trenton. Virginia's gone our way too. We're on a great path, and we're just so happy for everybody tonight. Are you going to give me a warning, or should I just go grab him? So don't start interviewing him right away, is what you're saying? Okay. Okay. When you hear the cheering, it means he's probably here. When they start cheering, he's going...
He's outside. He's on the phone outside. Do you want to take the shot? Because they're going to start cheering right now. He's on the phone right now. He should be coming in any second. Let me know when you're taking the shot.
We feel really good. We got so many people work so hard, and All the votes haven't been counted, but as soon as they do, I think we're going to be in a pretty good spot tonight.
I saw 63% of the vote is in. You are up. Are you keeping track of those numbers?
We're keeping track. We feel good. Waiting to talk to the other side to make sure that they feel the same as we do, but we feel very good right now.
What do you want to say to people watching? You are the next standing victor.
This is an exciting day, and so many people in this room worked very hard to make this happen, and we are not going to let Monmouth County down.
What's amazing is you speak to people in this room, and they've been knocking on doors, they've been making phone calls. People of all ages. You spoke to a little girl who was a fan of yours.
I think today we brought together Republicans, Democrats, Independents that want a new direction. And I think this is going to be very good. I'm excited to work with our new governor, Phil Murphy. I want to see all the votes counted tonight. And I think we feel very good very soon to give a victory speech.
Well, looking forward to it. Thank you very much. Thank you. Keep going with the crowd. So they're very excited to see him. He's still making his way around this room. A lot of people have been waiting for him to arrive. And they are just so excited. You can see this room is completely packed with people right now, hoping that Vin Gopal does give a victory speech soon. Back to you guys in the studio. Say that one more time. It's so hard to hear you. Okay. Thank you.
Governor-elect Phil Murphy! and he's not speaking yet, but let's just give it up for our newly elected Senator, Vin Gopal. Right now, we'd just like to have our three older candidates say a few words, Mayor Wilton and Dr. Margie Donovan.
Thank you, Chairman. I just want to say thank you to everyone that supported us tonight and throughout this race. It's been an amazing 9 months. We declared back in February, into March, marching in the St. Patty's Day Parade. But especially to our family, our friends, my wife Sarah, the girls, campaign, the Monmouth County Democrat staff, Chairman Brown, former Chairman Vin Gopal, and Vin, congratulations. You deserve it. You worked your ass off and it paid off. Proud to be on the team with you. I just wanted to beat that one, so. And to Dr. Donald, it was a pleasure running with you as a running mate. It was a great race. We worked hard. It's a tough county, but it is what it is. And thank you again. Thank you for all your support. And congratulations to Governor-elect Murphy and particularly to Vin Gopal, Eric Joanne. Congrats on running the board.
There's a lot of hope in this room. We all showed up to the polls. I'm thrilled about that. And we came out and we elected a new senator. It was my first time running, but it won't be my last. Running mate, it was a true pleasure. We were a team. We worked very hard every day after work. And again, I got to thank my fiance Ron for Nicola and my beautiful daughter Amalia, who was there every step of the way. Our whole team and everyone who showed up for us. You guys showed up, and that made the difference. So thank you.
We love you, Margie.
Now I just want to thank all of the Monmouth County Democratic Exec Board members that are present, the municipal chairs, our caucus chairs, all our friends in labor. We thank you for all the hard work so we can get across this line. Vin Gopal started something almost 5 years ago, and look where we are today! Yeah. Yeah. Now, let's not forget. We're not going to forget the re-election of our assembly members, Eric Hotallin and Joey Hotallin.
Well, you know, this is one of the reasons that we've won this election, because we're always doing things to save money. Instead of a stage, we're using a chair.
There you go.
That's how we do the Social Democrats do things. But I really want to say, it's very, you know, there's so many people here, it's incredible, but I really have to say thank you to everybody who helped us. First of all, our campaign staff was wonderful. They were working grueling hours, and they were working nonstop. And I really want to say thank you for what you have done, all of us. You know, I'm an IBEW member, and the unions came on strong. I want to say thanks to my business manager, Guy Peterson, Rob Shipko right here, Jimmy Moran, my friend George Rossi over there, and Jimmy Sisko. You know, they worked very hard for us, but it was also all the other unions that were there for us the whole way. The PBA was on board, the firemen, the nurses, everybody. The teachers were there for us. Everybody was there for us. And you know what? We had a great result. You can see why. Look at all these people that are here. It's incredible.
Yeah.
And you know, as you progress in this a little bit, you get a little bit smarter. So, you know, first thing I want to do is say thank you to my wife, Linda, over there. You know, we had a 9-month campaign, and my wife was there every step of the way for me, cooking me my meals and, you know, making my life comforting. And thank you, dear. I want to thank you for that. And my daughter, Diana, my other daughter came all the way from North Carolina, Amy Butcher over there. Left her 4 children at home, and here she is. I'm looking for my sister, Linda. There she is, Linda Sitko. Her husband, Billy. Linda came all the way from New York to be with us. I want to say thank you, Linda.
Right.
I love you. So let me just say this.
Vin.
Let me just say this. You know, we had a, we got elected 2 years ago and nobody really thought we could win then. This year, we had some doubts. We worked very hard, but there was so much troubling things out there on a federal level that we didn't know how that was going to affect our election. So we started really knocking on doors, working on this election in February when it was 0 degrees out. We were knocking on doors, working. We were knocking on doors when it was 100 degrees out, and we worked very, very hard. And we did our job as legislators, and we paved the way for Vin Gopal to be the senator that we have here today. And I can't say enough, I am just so happy right now that we have three people who will be working in the same direction for progress for the state of New Jersey. That's what we're elected for, and that's what I want to say. Thank you all for making that happen, and we will not let you down. Thank you all very much.
And he said, "I'm going to run against Beck." And Matt and I kind of looked at each other, and looked at each other again and said, whatever you want, Vin, we will do. I had the honor and privilege of nominating Vin back in March to be our next state senator. And we worked hard. See, 2 years ago, they said it was a fluke. Well, they can't say it tonight, can they? But there's no fluke in the 11th district. We control it. For the first time in well over 30 years, we got a state senator and two assembly people. And we're going to keep it as long as we want because we represent the people of Monmouth County. I am so honored and so proud. I've always been proud to serve on the executive director of and on the executive committee of Vin Gopal and now Dave Brown. And I am so honored. Where is he? I don't see him. I guess I'll keep talking until I see him. Well, when he comes back, I'll introduce him. This has been a dogfight. And they were nasty. They threw everything at him and nothing stuck. They lied, which Republicans, God forbid, if they ever tell a lie, huh? But it didn't work because we outclassed them. When they went low, we went high. And that's what Vin said. We're not getting nasty. We're gonna stay positive. We're going to take it to the people and let them decide who's the better candidate, the flip-flopper or the person that's going to do the job. And the voters spoke today. It is my honor and my privilege to introduce the next state senator from LD 11, my friend Vin Gopal.
It's been a long campaign. I just got off the phone with Senator Beck where she gracefully conceded and I thanked her for her service. I thanked her for her service to the state of New Jersey.
Zach, if you can hear me, he just said she
so
conceded.
Many people in this room worked so hard, it would be difficult to name everybody. But I am very excited that we had two fantastic Freeholder candidates this year that I know are going to be back. Let's hear for Brian Wilkins and Dr. Roger Jones.
Yeah, Brian.
And as our wonderful chairman said, we elected the first Democratic Assembly people in the history of the 11th District, Assemblyman Eric O'Talley and Assemblywoman Joanne Brown. Let's hear for them. To all the committee people, all the chairs, so many people worked hard. I want to thank our friends in organized labor, the laborers, the operating engineers, my good friend Pat Colligan from the PBA, Eddie Donnelly from the firefighters, the Monmouth County Education Association, Denise King, the IBEW, Local 9, the nurses, and so many groups in organized labor that stood with us. We will not let you down, and we understand that you are the backbone of this country, and we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Let's hear it. I want to thank some of my best vote-getters. My parents
yeah.
are here. If you can
yeah,
give
he's hand. Talking right now. He said she conceded.
My mom was going to people at the supermarket and saying, do you live in the 11th district? So. And to the beautiful and talented Christina Zuck, who's been by my side, if you can give her a round of applause. And the only one person here that was probably more passionate than our entire team
she
here.
She called him.
He is a machine, and we owe him a lot. That's Ritesh Shaw. Let's hear it for that. We had an outstanding campaign team. He had everything thrown at him, including a beautiful baby boy along the way, and that's our campaign manager, Axel. Let's hear it for Axel. And with him, I want to ask all of our field staff to come up here, please, led by Haley. I want them all to come up here. These kids came from all over the country, Ken and Haley, all of them, and they worked tirelessly each and every day. Zachariah, come on, Katie.
Where's Kayvon?
Kayvon, get them all up here. These kids worked tirelessly, and they worked hard. One of the best folks the Monmouth County Democrats has ever had, and I trust him more than anybody, is our executive director, Matt Anderson. Where's Matt? Matt. Eric and Joanne, also we want to bring up their outstanding legislative staff. Good news is you guys still have a job. Come on up. Evan, Tom. Their outstanding chief of staff, Joe LaBuddy. Let's hear it for Joe. In addition to our friends at the laborers, we have some friends that helped us thick and thin. I want to thank Janice Fuller, John Duffy, Laura Matos, Stephanie Albanese. Thank you all for everything you did each and every day these last 2 weeks. Camilla Diaz, where's Camilla? She made the money work at the end. Ashley, bring them all up. Don't be shy.
Ace, where are you?
Come on, Ace.
Where is
he?
Where is he?
A couple weeks ago, I want you to know, we met a 93-year-old woman who was living on $750 a month in rent. She was getting $800 a month in Social Security, and she was worried to death coming up to us in Ocean Township whether she's going to lose her food stamps. She has no family, 93 years old. We plan on visiting her this week to let her know that her senator and her assembly people will never forget her, and we will do everything we can for the people of Monmouth County, whether you're a Republican, Democrat, independent, to make sure we do the right thing, regardless of party politics, to move our state forward. We are excited to working with our new governor-elect, Phil Murphy. And finally, the message we've had since day one, I'm not going to do a lot of policy, but since day one, 565 towns, where's Mayor Fernicola? Lock Harbor, 194 people, 600 school districts. We will end, go up and down the state to end New Jersey's property tax madness, of municipal madness, no matter what political party you are. We'll take it on, finally create property tax relief for the people of New Jersey, and work with everybody to get that done. Where's Mike, president of the Monmouth County Conference of Local PBAs? Mike, thank you for everything. Our good friend, Chief Ray O'Hare from Keensburg, always had our back. Let's hear from Ray O'Hare. So many of you worked hard. I see volunteers, interns, staff people, folks like Tracy Buckley, who came in every day, Anita Clamber from Long Branch, where's Anita? So many folks who drove people to the polls, who believed in us. I want you to know that we will never let you down, and we will work hard each and every day. The responsibility that you have given me as your senator and to re-elect your assembly people, we take it seriously. And we're not going to be back 2 years from now or 4 years from now. We will be getting ready to go to work tomorrow to make sure that we bring real change to the people of Monmouth County who have needed it for a very long time. So from the bottom of my heart, all of our hearts, to each and every one of you, we will not forget what you have done for us. And to those who didn't vote for us, we want you to join us now, because we are on a mission to make this county a wonderful place. Thank you very much, and God bless you. I didn't hear the beginning of Bill Robinson's speech, but people told me to get there quickly. He put up thousands of lawn signs, and he is one of the many volunteers all over this county. To everyone who volunteered, that helped, to the over thousands of people, 3,000 people that donated to our campaign, donations of $10, $25, I personally look forward to reaching out to you in the weeks ahead to thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
Let's give a big round of applause.
Eric
Here's your song.
That was awesome.
Hey, what were they?
Well,
I must have been the only person to go up. Me and my wife.
You come and interview me again? I was a monster.
I want to also congratulate who's here with us tonight, the brand new mayor of Tinton Falls. Let's hear from Mayor Vito Perillo. Mayor. Sorry. And our chairman, I'd be remiss. We had Democratic victories all over this county, in Eatontown, in Red Bank. But the chairman's wife is the newest member of the Long Branch Board of Education. Congratulations, Natasha Brown.
Zach, if you... can hear me, we have Vin Gopal's father who can do an interview if you want to roll on it. We have his parents. Can you roll on it? Hello, hello. Hey, Zach, can you hear me?
People's person, he's always wants to do public service, help the people, and he wants to go forward.
Do you have any other children or just him?
I have one other son.
I'm excited.
Very excited.
Anything you want to say about
him? I'm so proud of him. And he worked very hard for me for about almost a year. It was a long, hard 1 year. I'm glad for the sex.
Yes, so I'll let you guys go mingle. It's been fine. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. There you have it. Vin Gopal's parents right over here. A lot of people are trying to see them right now. Congratulating them. They're very, very proud of their son.
I've been working for 28 years for my successor, and we finally made it tonight.
What does that mean for you? How are you feeling?
Well, it's like passing the torch on to a new generation. He's young, he's intelligent, he's good-looking and energetic, and he's got the right ideas for the people of the 11th District and the state of New Jersey, and he's going to go very far. Well, districting had a part to play in it, and also it's just been very tough in Monmouth County, which is generally a Republican county, although I was elected 3 times to the Board of Freeholders, but you had to be lucky and run in the right years. This was the right year for Vin and for Joanne Downey and Eric O'Talling. First time in a long time that we've had a completely blue 11th district, and I'm so proud of all of them. Stay in touch with the people. Constituent work is extremely important. And if he stays in touch with his constituents and responds to their questions and needs, he'll do very well.
Thank you so much for your time. Unbelievable right there. This room is so excited, everyone. It's just on cloud nine, right? Am I right?
Absolutely.
Tell me, what are you feeling right now?
Oh, great. I love the change.
And you are here because you are a big supporter and a volunteer for your mom.
Yes, I volunteer.
What are you going to say to him tonight?
Vin? He happens to be a friend of my son's. And I was just so excited for him.
Have you seen him yet?
Yes. I just spoke to him. He's going to do a great job.
Walking around the room, spoke with his parents, everyone is extremely excited to this win.
Sorry about that. I mean, enough, I got to go.
official, yeah. And we can officially congratulate you. What are you thinking right now?
I'm excited, and I owe a debt to a lot of people that stuck their necks out to help and took a risk, and I'm not going to let them down.
And we actually just spoke with John DiMicco. He was the last Democratic senator in the district. Pretty amazing. He said he's going to pass on the torch. He's excited for us.
It's been a long time, and my running mates, Eric and Joanne, are the first Democratic Assembly members ever to get reelected in the district. So I'm excited, and we need to move forward, and the state's got a lot of problems. I'm excited to get right into it.
Why do you think District 11 had this shift all of a sudden this year?
I think folks worked hard, and at the end of the day, it was Republicans, Democrats, independents, business owners, employees, young, old, that came together and wanted a different direction, and I think that we're going to do what we can to make sure that happens.
So how are you going to be celebrating tonight?
Probably go to bed at some point, catch up, and start getting to work.
Absolutely. Well, this is a dream come true. I've been campaigning for Democratic candidates for Senate for 28 years, and I'm glad I stayed on the top side of the grass in enough time to see him get elected. And he's going to be great.
Thank you, Judge. Thank you.
Taking a live look at Vin Gopal, shaking hands with all his supporters, all the people who have worked very hard to help get him this win tonight. And we just spoke with him, and also the last Democrat to hold the seat for Senator for District 11. He gave his words of wisdom. There they are right now, talking to each other. Pretty amazing sight to be seen.
Thank you. We are so excited because honestly now we feel that LD11 is blue. We're no longer purple, we're definitely not red, we are blue. And we are ready to represent all of the people and do all the things we've intended on doing before, but blocked, we couldn't do. And with a governor who's also a Democrat, we're gonna get these things accomplished for all of our people here in the state.
How are you feeling right now?
I just feel good.
Excited.
Excited, we worked very hard and it was a victory that we earned.
Yes.
I don't know what the stats are, but somebody said it hasn't been done. I don't know, but...
No, this is the first time, and again, because we were not considered able to be blue for the longest time. We were not Democratic, but it's changed, and now we represent more of the people and their values, what they're looking for here. So that's why we're excited, because we're ready to do the work for all the people.
What's first on the agenda? I know you just knew it, so you can congrats and celebrate.
You know, we're going to continue what we started on. Changing the school funding formula so it's more fair for everybody throughout the state. We're going to do pay equity for women. We're going to make sure that we are paying attention to our gun laws. We want to make sure mentally ill people can't get a hold of guns. So, you want to go on more?
I got to be very simple. We just want to make the state better to live
in.
We want to make it more affordable. We want people to say that they're proud to live in the state of New Jersey.
Tonight is a night to celebrate.
Tonight, we don't even know. We're just excited to be here with everybody and our families, our friends, and literally everybody in this room helped us. And we're very lucky.
I don't know how much gas we got left in the tank. We both started at 6 o'clock in the morning at the train station. We've been working hard all day. So we're just
going to enjoy
this. We've actually been working ever since we got elected last time. And we started again our campaign back in January. So we've never stopped, and we won't, because we know how important it is to do the job that we're elected to do.
Thank you both so much for taking the time.
Thank you.
A lot of people here want to say hi to you, so we'll let you go. Thank you very much. There you have it.
This is one of our candidates. Congratulations to the winners. Good job tonight. Special goes to this song, going back to 1975. Paul Walden and the Bruins, featuring Tim Antonis. Please wait for everybody.
I'll just cue it. I'll say take a listen or something. I'll cue you.
Oh, well, the 1970s.